So as we all know, this past Friday, Donald Trump had sent out a post on Truth Social, got him in a lot of trouble in court, that said, if you go after me, I'm coming after you. Now, what's really interesting about this statement from Donald Trump on Friday, and again, I've already talked about the legal issues with it. What's interesting about it is that even before he sent that out, we had gotten multiple reports out there in the public about how Donald Trump was going to make his second term a 100% revenge tour, going after anyone and everyone that has ever investigated him, and in some cases, just people who've pissed him off. And the day before Trump sent out that post on Truth Social, again, that got him in a lot of trouble, there was a report from Rolling Stone where they spoke to current advisors to Donald Trump, where they openly admitted and said, oh yeah, one of them said, there are almost too many targets to keep track of with regard to the people that Trump is going to go after if he ever makes it back to the White House. Here's what they said. He's assembling a roster. This is from Raw Story, by the way. He's assembling a roster of loyalist lawyers and planning revenge-minded special counsels and special prosecutors to investigate Jack Smith, Manhattan District Attorney Alvin Bragg, and other prosecutors. He's also considering a wave of pardons for his associates and supporters, including January 6 rioters, the Rolling Stone report said. So he's going after everybody. Anyone and everyone, if you've pissed him off, if you've gone after him, he is, in fact, coming after you. These are from people that are close to him, people that are a part of the campaign. And it's bad enough that he would pardon the Capitol rioters, but I do think at this point he definitely would do that. They've said he actually wants to do the pardons right out of the gate. You know, within the first few days of his administration, he'd pardon some of his friends, too, that may need him. But this is horrifying. I know Republicans, Marjorie Taylor Greene out there talking about like this prosecution of Trump, this is what communism is. She literally said that on Sunday on the Sunday morning talk shows. That's not actually what communism is. But anyway, she uses that word to describe everything she doesn't like. Chef overcooks her food. Boom, this food is communism now. But what Trump is doing, what he's planning on doing, according to his advisors, this is authoritarianism. This is basically saying you cannot uphold the law if that means having to come after me. I am putting myself above the law. So therefore, if you have come after me, I have to prosecute you. He's literally doing the things that Republicans are accusing Biden of doing. They're accusing the Democrats of doing them. Hell, they've held 7 months of weaponization of the government hearings. And here you have Trump's own people saying, we're going to weaponize the government against these people. And conservatives are out there like, oh yeah, hell yeah. I don't know. Because stories like this make me think like, we're effed. Totally screwed, beyond redemption, beyond salvation. This country is done. But then I do remember for a second, this guy's not president yet, right? We still got time. He could still be in prison. But this is what they want. And if it's not Trump doing it from the White House, if another Republican gets in there, they'll do the same damn thing. So that's what we have to be aware of. Everything the Republicans accuse Democrats of doing is actually an admission that that is what they want to do. Remember that and carry that with you. Because the most important thing in 2024 is defeating any and every Republican at the polls that we can. They've told us what they're going to do. It doesn't involve legislating. It doesn't involve making your life any better. Democrats for sure are not perfect. But these people, they want to put you in jail because you disagree with them. The two parties are not alike. The two parties do have quite a bit of daylight between them. I know there's plenty of pundits out there like, there's no difference between Democrats and Republicans. It takes a very special kind of stupid to think that this day and age. You look at what the Republicans do, you look at what the Democrats do. Again, Democrats are not perfect. They screw up all the time. They do things I don't like and I criticize the hell out of them for it. But they've never actively tried to kill me. They're not the ones sending me death threats or any of the other folks that do this. We're not getting death threats from Democrats. It's the Republicans, and they mean it when they say it. They will turn the federal government into a tool to take out as many of their enemies as they can. And if you don't think you're on that list too, then you got another thing coming.
Ring of Fire has fresh content 7 days a week, so if you want to be reminded about it, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the little bell to be notified every time a new video goes up.